Hey guys, I'm Naya and welcome back to the channel. First of all, before we begin with today's video, I want to say thank you so, so much because we hit 5,000 subscribers officially now. When I went to bed, there was like a couple missing and my husband woke me up in the middle of the night when, you know, the channel actually hit 5,000 subscribers. And I've mentioned this in a lot of videos. I'm incredibly grateful. And as you know, I have a giveaway still going on. It's still open and you can still enter if you maybe haven't, because in the next video, so the one after this one, I will be announcing 5 winners. So yeah, with that being said, I want to say thank you once more. And for today's video, it's just going to be a quick one. We're going to go over the OTS pack 19 spoilers because the entire set got spoiled. So yeah, we're just gonna, you know, go over everything and I'll let you know my thoughts. So first we have 3 ultimate rares, and Fallen of Albas was known, of course. Overall, I think this card is a really good choice as an ultimate rare. You know, Despia is very dominant and this card is basically what the entire lore is centered around, what every single fusion is centered around, and it's just it's a very good choice. But then we come to Water Enchantress, and if I'm being completely honest, I'm not a big fan of that. I see those cards as, you know, Konami's way of just incentivizing the players even more to buy them. And by those cards, I mean these kinds of, you know, artworks. And when I think that's what the case is, I cannot really get behind that idea. But other than that, if we just look at the actual card, you know, it's cool. The Brave engine basically just shaped the game and impacted a lot of decks. So it's cool that they're giving it some kind of recognition. Although the super rare Jacobak would probably be better, but that's besides the point. It's not in the OTS. And yeah, Water Enchantress, like, it's an interesting choice, and it's probably going to look very good and just, it's going to be a beautiful OT, but it's still a bit weird because it did get the collector's rare printing in Grand Creators, so I don't really see the point in, you know, printing a lot of cards in a lot of high rarities. But you know, they can do whatever they want, of course. So yeah, that's it for Water Enchantress, and then we have Skill Drain. I think that's really cool. Like, I get the card is not really seeing a lot of play, and maybe some other cards, spell straps, I mean, would be a bit of a better choice. But yeah, Skill Drain in itself, I think, is a really cool card. And, you know, it having an OT, there's nothing wrong with that, in my opinion. Then we have super rares. And we have the Monarch, Trap Eater, Pain Painter. Like, a couple of these are basically just, overall in the OTS, I mean, are either Edison format support or just cards that had only one printing and were expensive. So when it comes to Pain Painter, for example, and then we also have the DDD stuff, which, you know, there's no Kepler. I've heard and read a lot of talk about that. Obviously, that's sad, but we can only hope, you know. You do have like 3 DDD cards, and the Flame King Genghis, I think, is like the best one out of all of them. And it having a super printing, I think, is going to look very good. And then the Performa Pal Monster and Forbidden Chalice. So this is it for the super rares. Forbidden Chalice is a super, I think, is going to look beautiful. And then we have the, like I mentioned before, a couple cards were just very expensive. You know, you have the Hercules Beetle and the Kuwagata. And yeah, like, some of those commons are like, you know, it's cool. It's just filling up spots. And you have Knight of Zayden, of course, because of the errata. Gores, which is interesting. Lone Fire Blossom, because of the synergy with Therians, I assume. Like, it's just, it's a good card. Like, Lone Fire Blossom is just a good card. Although, you know, it is only a common reprint, so at that point you would probably play a higher rarity. And then you have heroic stuff and a couple pendulum stuff, which I think is really nice. Like, of course, Wisdom Eye and Skull Cravat Joker are much better looking in super. But you know, you have Fairy Tail Snow, which I think this is a great addition to the OTS. This Chudo as well. Like, it's just nice when stuff comes off the ban list and it actually gets a reprint to have just more cards available to players. So I think that's really nice. And then you have the heroic stuff, a random Symphonic Warrior spell, which I haven't read it yet. I need to I'm like glancing over it and I can see something about symphonic counters. I'll read that later. Basically, you have the this spell card and then you have the red reboot, which you know is also cool addition. Like overall, this set is not exactly. It didn't exactly get me hyped up. Like some cards are not bad, you know. And you have the Forbidden Chalice, Red Reboot, also a cool reprint, but still, you know, it has prettier rarities, and they're not exactly, you know, not accessible. So you can get your hands on better looking cards than those right here in the OTS when it comes to Pendulum stuff, or you know, even Snow. At the end of the day, it is only at one. So you would probably invest in a super rare. I don't know. Like, it's really to each their own, but looking over it once more, like you have a couple stuff that really makes sense, like the expensive things and the Night Assailant. But yeah, other than that, I just think there's better cards to be put in this set. And overall, I think OTS packs tend to disappoint players because we tend to come up with a lot of ideas as to what could have a super rare, and obviously not every single card can have one. I don't know. I don't think this is one of the better OTS packs of the last ones, but that's just it, you know, that's really just my opinion. Oh, before we wrap this video up, I almost forgot to mention, from what I understand, tokens are never spoiled beforehand. Like they're not on the card database, of course. So there's still the option of the Sorcerer token and the Adventurer token to be in the set, which hopefully we see happen. So there's that as well. And yeah, with that being said, let me know what you think of the set, which cards are maybe you looking forward to or might be picking up. Sub to the channel, of course. A lot of you are still not, and I would love for you to be part of this community by subbing. And before we really end this video, please go enter the giveaway if you still haven't. I would love to have a lot of people enter. And yeah, if you like the video, like it, give me a sub, check out all of the social media, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace!